In today's video, I'm going to talk about the Shopify fix for your Google Merchant Center error, disapproved product value for missing color, size, age group, and gender. Hi, I'm Clarice Lin, the ROI doctor who helps small businesses and online stores get more customers and sales by getting on Google and YouTube page one. In today's video, I'm going to teach you and show you some screenshots on how you can follow along and fix those issues on your Google Merchant Center account. If you are trying to get Google Merchant Center account set up, you will know by now there are two different types of listings, which is the standard listings and the enhanced listings. So if you qualify for standard listings, your products will be found on Google search results and Google image search results. And if you want to be eligible for enhanced listings, then one of the attributes to fill up is gender, the size, color, and the age group for your product type. And this is mainly meant for apparel and accessories. That's the term determined by Google. That basically means that if you are selling an item on your Shopify store that's supposed to be put on a human being, cap, cloth, dress, whatever, you will need these four attributes. If you're not sending all this information to Google Merchant Center account, then your product is going to be disapproved and it's not going to be shown on the Google Shopping tab. If you want to know how to fix it on the Shopify site, then you need to follow along with my screenshots. I'm going to show you step by step on how you can fill this information up to make sure that your products will be approved. Let's head on to my computer.
Right now, we are on the main page for registration of free listings. To resolve the error for missing value, which is the missing value for gender, age group, size, and color, this is where criteria is listed by Google. Let's take a look over here. You can see there is additional eligibility requirements for enhanced listings on the shopping tab, which means that if you want your products to be listed on shopping tab for free, even if you are not paying for ads, you need to follow the policies for free listings as well as for shopping ads. This is the official page for enhanced listings requirements. So there are other attributes that you need to take note as well for your products. But today specifically, we are going to look at the four missing attributes that you have encountered, which is missing value for color, size, age group, gender. As you can see, Google has listed that these attributes are required for clothing and accessories. If you're selling something that's put on a human being, then you will need to fill this up. If you don't have this information filled up, then Google will deem that your product information is insufficient and your products will not be eligible to be shown on Google Shopping tab. You will still be found on Google search and image search. It's just that you won't be on the shopping tab, which defeats the entire purpose because we want to be on the shopping tab where browsers and shoppers are. So to do that, you need to go to your Shopify store, head back to it, to your Shopify store, and this is where you can amend those values or fill in those values. If you have your shopping app, which is a Google Shopping app, installed, you will be able to see under your sales channel on your main page right here. To update those information, go to products, all products, and click on each of your products. Over here, I've selected one of the products here, and you can see on the top right hand corner, you can see more actions. You can click on that and you can select Google fields, and this is what you will see, a dialog box coming up which allows you to update or fill in more values for each of your products, so as to fulfill the criteria for enhanced listings. If you need help for filling up the Google product category, over here I have another video which explains to you exactly how to select the right category, so head right onto it. I'm going to also put the link down in the description and pinned comment, so do check that out. So let's look at the missing values age group. Over here it's listed just simply as age. As you can see, this is a drop-down list box, which means that the values are fixed. The main values that are shown there are newborn, infant, toddler, children, and adult. If you are selling a product that's meant for adults of different age or even for a specific age group, you would just select adult. For gender, so you can see it's a drop-down box, which means the values are fixed. Google will not accept other values. Available values are female, male, and unisex. So you can select that accordingly. And for the color of your products, you can fill it right here. It's in text format, so you can see there's no value check. Spell out exactly the color. For size, you can put in the size here, size type as well, and your size system or the size over here. So once you've updated that, the values will be saved and sent to Google. Once you hit on the save button over here, right now it's gray out, but if you update this information, this will appear as a green button for you to click on save. Once you click on save, this information will be saved and will be pushed to over to Google Merchant Center account. If you have set up an automated feed, then you don't have to update this information or download any information to upload over on the Google Merchant Center site. Give it some time and this data will be pushed over to Google and Google will update it on the site and the errors will be resolved. Give it a few days. If you don't see any changes after a week or so, then you can contact Google. Otherwise, it should all work out. For each of the products that you have encountered with this missing value, gender, age group, color, and size, go to each of the products and update each one of them accordingly and click save. So you have to do it manually and then you click save. And that's it.
Now that you have fixed this issue, what you have to do is to wait. Be patient and let Google review all your products and come back to you. You can head on to the Google Merchant Center account to check on the status of your products, but you just have to wait because there are many other Shopify stores or other e-commerce stores who are also doing the same things as you. So there are limited Google resources. In my own experience, you should ideally wait for about a week or so before you try to get in touch with them to try to accelerate this progress. And I hope that's going to help your products get shown on Google listings to get more sales. If you're struggling with all of this, getting listed on Google, or if you want to run some ads, I also offer support on that. You can check out my services on clarislin.com/services on how I help Shopify stores get on Google really quickly so you can spend more of your time on selling your products instead. So if you enjoyed this video, hit on the like button and don't forget to subscribe and hit on the notifications bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.